What is happening, everybody? John Denton here with another album reaction. What a busy Friday it was. Yes, Kanye didn't drop. He may have dropped by the time you're seeing this video. Who knows? Who knows? I'm assuming he won't. But not only did we have Logic, but we also had Kid Laroi with his first mixtape, album, whatever you want to call it, project, regardless. I'm excited to do this because everything I've heard from the young Aussie has been really good, actually. I'm hearing good things, loads of people in my comments, loads of people on social media asking me to react to this one. I was always planning on it, so here we are now. If you want to see this reaction in uncut, extended form, that is there on my Patreon. There's a link down in the description. Go and click that. It's at the $5 tier, along with all album reactions uncut on there, and four extra album reactions exclusive on Patreon every single month. Come follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Subscribe to this channel if you're new around here. We're road to 200k now. What a year. Let's do this. Why do I always leave my headphones on the floor? Fucking weirdo. Alright.
Now tell me this doesn't sound weird. If you were a girl, you would think this shit was weird. You're gonna text me good morning. We don't talk all day. Drown my sorrows
in this bottle. This is already making me feel really old. But it's fine. And you don't need me like I need you. So if I go, maybe I'll free you. So maybe, maybe I'm driving me crazy. Maybe it's me and it's not you. I'm not too good at admitting why I fuck up, but maybe, maybe. I mean, he's definitely obviously in the Post Malone Juice WRLD lane. Like, there's no doubt about that. He has a little bit more angst to his voice, I guess, and a little bit more sort of raspiness and rawness. But he's actually got a good ear for melody, perhaps even better than those two, just from what I've heard. Especially when singing songs like this, Post Malone can kind of do other things, other types of music. But I'm not saying he's better than those guys. I mean, I've barely heard anything. But this song, it sounds pretty good. Who can save me? No way that I'll ever change. I'm down to lay down next to my own bro. Yeah, it's a decent lyric, isn't it? Maybe I'm driving me crazy. Maybe it's me and it's not you. I'm not too good at admitting why I fuck up. Okay, yeah, that's a decent track. Good melody, good beat. I mean, I'm not going to deeply connect with his lyrics, most likely, because I'm over twice his age. Easily over twice his age, and that's absolutely fine. So I just kind of put myself in the mindset. I can still remember being a teenager quite well, even though it was a long time ago. So I just kind of put myself in that mindset of people who are going to be connecting with him, people who are more around his age, and also use the experience I've had in listening to music my whole life to kind of try and break down the musical side of it, his ability, his potential. That was a good, catchy song. He definitely seems to have that in his locker easily. In everything that I've heard from him, so no complaints so far. That was good. I know that we ain't getting along, but I wanna see you on your own tonight. Oh, fuck, let's get drunk and then fucked up. I just wanna feel I'm too young to get drunk, but do what you want. I said, baby, you better show me. God, and these hoes feel like they owe me. Everything I've heard from Lil Mosey just doesn't work for me at all. Just the way that he kind of like slides in and off beat through pockets and things like that. He's never said anything in the songs that I've heard of any interest whatsoever. Probably just sound like an old guy now, but whatever. That's just my thoughts on the kid. But Kid Laroi, yeah, good. This song I'm not really enjoying as much as the last one, although I quite like the little piano refrain. The difference between him and some of the other people that make music like this, including Lil Mosey, he really actually can sing, but he's using a kind of style on his voice to create this kind of energy on the track, and to be similar to Post Malone and Juice as well, obviously his mentor. You can tell when he'll go up quite high in the scale and things like that. He actually can sing. I'd be interested to hear him sing in a slightly cleaner style. Not that he should do that on his music at all, but just to know what his voice is like. And I think that combined with his sort of understanding of more complex melodies that you often hear in songs like this. How many songs do we hear in this kind of melodic trap style from newer young artists that just sound, I call them Fisher Price rhymes, like the Fisher Price melodies, man. They're just na 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 na, oh, hell on earth. Whereas he is actually singing songs with different structure and melody and verses and chorus and stuff like that, and that does make a difference. And you can definitely say the same for Juice WRLD's better music, Post Malone's better music as well. So I think that's why I'm enjoying it. Listen, this isn't going to blow me away, but you know, I'm also acutely aware, like I said, I'm over twice Killer Roy's age, and this is music that's going to connect better, I think, if you're around his age. The stuff that he's talking about, he shouldn't be necessarily connecting to me, it wouldn't make sense, but I am impressed by his ability and his skill level, and I do think that he's probably a cut above a lot of the artists making similar music right now. I can't come unless you kiss me. I don't know her, but she's saying that she missed me. So I really like the subtle guitar in this one. I'm guessing this is Corbin. Instantly, I'm not connecting with his voice. Show me the hell in the drop top. I need you to save me before I fuck up and go too far. Precious dying. Better off dead. You don't wanna come around. Actually, to be fair, they sound quite good harmonizing together. Pour my heart out on the floor, now it's leaking. Spent 2,000 on an effing, and don't make me squeeze it. Sorry, Corbin, I'm not, your voice just doesn't work for me. Alright, so he's found a completely different pocket on the beat there to change up the song. This is what I'm saying about this kid. He has musical talent, and honestly, I think some of the kids that are coming through making music on this type of beat at the moment, they don't. They just don't. It sounds really nice. String's a little bit overblown, but fine. Obviously, heard this one, got a reaction to this song on my channel. First time I heard Kid Leroy, but I'll listen again. Good track. Well, now, I always like to talk about the cover art on new projects. I meant to do it earlier, but let's do it now. It's just a little sort of manga-style, anime-style cover. Obviously, him there with the girl, he's holding her heart. Like, it's a nice image. It makes me feel like I am too old to be listening to this album, but that's probably my own thing. She's stabbing a heart as well behind him, I believe. It looks a little bit generic. If I was going to be honest, that wouldn't stand out to me, and it wouldn't make me realise what I was listening to. There may be some little Easter eggs in what's written up those buildings there. I don't think it's a great cover, to be honest. I'd rather see a picture of him, but I understand what they're going for. Tell me why it's so hard to say goodbye. If I keep thinking about our memory, then it's gonna be in memory of me. Tell me why that's why my heart's so cold. And I just can't even come on lie. I think that I'm better off without you with me tonight forever. And tell me why it's so hard to say goodbye. This isn't an amazing track, but again, just thank you for switching up your melody and your patterns on these songs. They're making proper songs. It's not just repetitive, absolute fucking crap. So thank you, Kid Leroy, for just being a cut above a lot of what we're hearing these days. Much better. Enjoyable record, genuinely. But I can't be mad, because I do the same thing. I do the same thing. And again, much more of a proper R&B vibe on this track. Why is everybody speaking to American? That's what's confusing me. Strings again, but that was a good 1:49. I know that you're mad at me, give an attitude. Can I make you feel comfortable? Got a lot to say, who you lying to? You. Come on. I just keep on running back to you. I just keep on running back to you. I just keep on running. Every time I'm expecting the song to come and it just to be middle of the road and filler, the songs are getting better. So fair play to the sequencing of the project. I love the fact it's a nice short project as well. It suits the age range of the people he's going for. It suits him as an artist. We're getting like a taste of his ability, some skits in there as well. So nice musical variety while all sticking in the same lane. And I must admit, I'm just thoroughly enjoying the project. It's been a really enjoyable listen.
We fight every day and night. You want me to make the time. You are so sad and slow. And I'm so sick of wishing. All of the times I fucked up, fuck love. Got me thinking while I pull my cup up. Tonight is a memory of you. I'm getting fucked up. I am. And oh, baby, I've been
Proof positive that, you know, he's been listening to R&B. Because obviously the interpolation here.
I need you to mind.
Also, like, I mean, listen, it's about teenage relationships, so I'm not going to get too hung up on it, although it's extremely important and dominates your mind when you're that age. So I also don't want to diminish those feelings, because they're about as real as you can get when you're that age. I like the fact that this is like a, you know, it's gone on a journey in its own personality throughout this little mini project here. In that, ultimately, the final song's called Selfish. So he's saying that, you know, ultimately he's probably at fault for all of this. And I think that's a nice little cautionary, self-cautionary tale. A nice little, yeah, rather than just like blatant misogyny that you quite often hear.
Cause I'ma be selfish. I'm gonna be selfish.
Okay, so we've gone full circle. Okay, there's a nice, nice little concept to it.
No one can help me. Oh, I'm gonna be selfish. I'm gonna be selfish. Ashes burning and crashing. Why can't I get past it? Why can't I get past it? And girl, you changed up the best one.
It's a good project. It really is. It's not outstanding. There's nothing on there that was really mind-blowing, like, oh my god, you need to listen to this one track right now. But I liked it as like a psychical little project, and I was actually going to go and do some research onto his musical background to see if he has like a classical trained background, or has been playing a lot of instruments since he was young or something along those lines, because his innate knowledge at finding all these different pockets in the songs and structure and everything like that is quite impressive for a kid his age. It reminds me of someone with a lot more of experience in making music. So in that respect, I do think he is a cut above a lot of the music that's coming out right now, including some of the features on his own record, not Juice WRLD. Overall, for a first reaction score, I think I'll go for a 7. I think that this is a record that will deeply connect with some people and they will want to award it a higher score. I also think it's a record that will do nothing for certain people, like if you just prefer rap or you just prefer rock or anything like this. I don't think this is really going to do anything for you. If you prefer R&B with a much better singing voice, understandable. So for me, I'm going to go 7 because I think there's more potential from Kid Laroi to create something of a higher level, and that's exactly what you'd want from somebody so young, to be showing this much potential right now and just knowing what can come in the future as he gets older, more confident, more experienced, works with different people, all that sort of stuff. So yeah, an enjoyable project, nice and short as well, which I think is essential. I'm sure there's a temptation to double the length of this record, or, you know, maybe even add 20 minutes onto it with some songs that are on the cutting room floor. Definitely of the mindset that that is not the move. Get a 30-minute project out that people are going to stream from back to front. It's a proper album, whether it's a mixtape or an album, whatever you want to call it. It makes sense in context with each other. I'm sick of these 1-hour, 16-minute albums when you've got filler all through it. Like, what's the point, really? This leaves me with a good taste in my mouth. This makes me want to hear more Kid Laroi. So yeah, shout out to him, shout out to his fans, because I know a lot of you guys have been on at me to react to this album. It was always part of the plan. Absolutely keep those requests coming. You know, it's all good. Come follow me on social media if you want to see this in uncut form. That is there on the Patreon link down in the description. Subscribe to the channel if you're new around here and you made it all this way and you're not subscribed. What are you doing? Guys, I'll catch you on the next video. We just keep it rolling. Road to 200k, baby. All right, catch you on the next one. Boys.